What's good, members? It's your boy Mr. Lacoste, and I'm obviously back with another trading video. So today is the same day I recorded the secrets you never knew on about Forex or something, I think. But it's the same video where I'm wearing the same shirt. So yeah, I basically recorded that today. So just a little update, because I just checked my charts now and it's all blues. So I just wanted to update you guys on the 300 challenge, which I did achieve it. I did double the account yesterday because I deposited 300 last week, and I doubled it yesterday. So yesterday's amount, it was on 626, if I'm not sure. I will maybe just put a screenshot here just to be sure. So that was yesterday's balance. So yesterday I did withdraw $310, just to be exact. So then after withdrawing 310, I was left with 316, I think, in the ZAR account. Yeah, I think so. So after withdrawing 310 and keeping the $316, I then deposited it into my Great British Pound account, which I'll show here. So I deposited it in that yesterday. Then I placed one trade. Yeah, I placed one trade yesterday, which was on NASDAQ. It was a sell, and I basically doubled the amount. So it's like from 300, I took the account to 600. Then from that 600, I withdrew 300. I was left with 300 again. I took that 300 to 600 again. So I'm confused with the number. So in overall, I made let me just double check. In overall, I made 1,226. Yo, it's crazy, eh? From 300, I made 1,226. It's almost like I tripled, not even tripled, quadrupled the account. From let me show you the trade. So this is the account or the trade on the Great British Pound, which, yo, it's crazy. Imagine from 13, so 13 Great British Pound, I think it's 300, or, well, yeah, somewhere there. So now it's, yo, just, yo, crazy, né? I cannot also believe it, but yeah, it is a real account. It is a real account. So for now, okay, so that's the update on the 300 challenge I did, which is, the 300 challenge was based on, like, since most brokers have a minimum deposit, or the requirement for the minimum deposit is 300. So that was the 300 challenge we tried, and we basically succeeded. Because imagine 300 in the case. Oh, it's crazy. But yeah, I'm just basically gonna be explaining how I caught this trade, which was yesterday's trade, which doubled or basically quadrupled the account. So yeah, I'm basically just going to be talking on how I saw the structure, why I opened a sell and not a buy, and whatnot. So yeah, with all that said, let's get into the charts. Okay, so now that we are logged into the charts, or have the charts in front of us. So yeah, this is the basic setup which I had for NASDAQ yesterday, which I saw. So I sold it from there. I sold it there. Since I saw that no price, okay, let me just remove everything, then start over. For those of you that don't have a clue of what's going on, just even wondering, oh, what's this guy explaining? So we started off on the 4-hour chart, as you guys can see. So right off the back, when we trade Forex, we always look for zones, or yeah, basically zones. Price, not price action, but we are looking for zones, like support structures, resistance structures, and whatnot. So off the back, I can see that here I have my first resistance structure. Why I say so is because in the past
when price reached that structure, we can see that it was followed by a rejection. It's basically impulse move and a rejection. It failed to break that levels. So when it came back this time, it did the exact same. It pushed up, failed to break, it dropped a bit, pushed back up, failed to break once again, forming a double top formation. So for those that know what double top formation is, basically know that it signals, or it's how should I say this? It basically gives us what's this? What's the word? Okay, it basically confirms that the market is in a seller's what's this? Seller's move. In short, it basically indicates that we are about to sell in short terms, for those of you that don't understand. So after I got my resistance zone, I drew up my trend lines. Now for those that know what trend lines are, whatnot, so yeah, in this case we had a trend line breakout, as you can see. No, let me go back. So we had our first touches here, second touch here, which it broke out at the third touch. So if you can look closely, the third touch breakout, it was okay, it reached the level of resistance which it showed us in the past. That's how we got it. So after it reaches that, it reached the third touch on our trend line. After that, it broke out. So every time we know, or when we trade trend breakouts, we always wait to enter at the resistance or the retracement. So it did break out. That was the retracement. This is where most people could have entered the trade now. But with Nasdaq, or the for this short time I've been trading Nasdaq, I always know that nah, sometimes it does form that retracement, and sometimes it does just drops from that retracement, and sometimes it also comes back to test that price again. So that's what happened with me. So instead of entering my sales from here, I waited for it to basically give me another confirmation that we are selling, or that the market is in a seller's market. So yeah, it broke out, retraced, came back down again, got support from somewhere here, which it failed to break, went back down, formed a double top formation. Everyone that trades Forex should know by now, double top formations signify or indicates a sell, basically. So now that you know that, I basically waited for price to break this structure I have here, because this would be my support structure, signifying that, or indicating, once we do break this level of support, which we did, we will wait for the retest. We wait for the retest, then we enjoy the move down. So the retest did happen. Let me just remove this so I show you guys. So this was a beautiful trade, guys. I'm not even complaining. So yeah, we did break out the structures, or we did break through. There is that retracement. So that green candle is our retracement. That's where I entered my sell from now. Then just dropped into profits right away. So yeah, this was a very easy trade I caught. So now I'm basically gonna be holding it up until the previous support structure, which is all the way down here. You guys can see. So this is what I'm expecting for Nasdaq to drop all the way. Okay, so in case it doesn't drop all the way and it tries going back, or it turns into a buy, I just did this. So what this is, I moved my stop loss from somewhere here now to break even, meaning that even if the market does try to basically, or if even if the market does turn into buyer's market, meaning that it's gonna surpass. Okay, yeah, let me just remove the arrow and show you guys what I mean. So we did lock profits. So in case the market maybe drops a bit and then decides to shoot back up, You see, if it does this, it's basically gonna mean that we are in negatives. But then, now luckily I moved my stop loss, as you can see there. So this is my stop loss. So I moved it from this or from there, because my stop loss was there first. So I moved it from there to break even, meaning that if we do, or if the market does try to push back up, it's gonna close us into with profits and not negative. So yeah, that's how I basically doubled or quadrupled this small account. Sure guys, it's really impressive. And for those that are wondering whether it's a real or not, there you go. So we did withdraw from this account, you guys can see, and we are still expecting to withdraw profits.